good, YouTube? It's your boy Dev back again for another first listen. Y'all know who that is right there. Now, Trap Soul is probably one of the most popular videos on my channel. It's also one of the original videos I've done in my first year of doing YouTube. I've been doing YouTube now. It's been 5 years because I think Trap Soul came out in 2015, I believe, or early 2016. Don't quote me on that. I do remember listening to it somewhere between the hot, like, it was cold. So, 2015, 2016 is really the only time Florida gets cold. There's only 2 months where Florida gets cold. December, first week of January. Anyways, Bryson Tiller is back. He is finally back 5 years later. There's a lot of things, you know, a lot of speculations going around, a lot of theories going around, what's been going on with his life. Look, I don't really care at the end of the day. I always talk about the music, all right? And I never had anything personal against Bryson Tiller. Whenever I've talked about Bryson Tiller as a musician, I always say that Trap Soul was the album that kind of just took his career off, and he's kind of just been, you know, leaning towards that Trap Soul album, and, you know, it's been carrying him. A lot of you guys, wherever you guys, what the fuck was that shit called? True to Self, self-titled, no self. I call it straight trash. I don't think it was great, but it did have my favorite song of Bryson Tiller, Set It Off. Set It Off is one of my favorite Bryson Tiller tracks to date. I just honestly think that, you know, while it is hard to, you know, succeed Trap Soul, my thing is, I feel like True to Self just wasn't good at all. It didn't fit. It didn't sound great. And even Bryson Tiller in an interview, you know, admitted himself that it was a body of work that he really didn't want to do. So I think that I can have my opinion. It is what it is. I'm not trying to get mad at you guys. I'm just glad that he is back. Now, I did say there was a lot of pressure on, you know, Bryson. I said there was a lot of pressure, man. Everybody's been waiting for the album. You know, it's kind of like the Frank Ocean effect. Remember when everybody was waiting for, you know, the Frank Ocean album, and then he came out with Blonde and Endless, both fire classics, and he did the exact thing that he said he was going to do, he did. Now, Bryson said he's dropping 2 albums. I'm just trying to see if he's actually going to drop some fire. Because the 2 singles that he dropped, which are already on here, this is a 10-track, I'm going to call it EP. This is a 10-track EP album. I've already listened to 2 tracks. Always and Forever is a banger. But Inhale is a little mediocre to me. You know, it's kind of just, you know, I thought it was an intro to his album. It's in the middle of the album. I don't do too much talking though, man. Like always, been talking too much, man. We got Bryson Tiller, Anniversary. Y'all ready? Hey, man, I know I be talking too much. I always be talking. You know what I'm saying? I just, you know, I'm just ready, man. Look, I ain't, you know, my hopes is high. My expectations is low. I'm ready to enjoy, man. Let's go.
Worrying about and trying to figure out what they, if they gonna like it or not. Oh, man, you gonna have about 5 years go by. Next thing you know, you ain't gonna want to do this shit.
That's so true. Like, you had Trap Soul, and I feel like when you had all that momentum, all that buildup, and then you literally just let it go to waste. Just like Kanye said, don't ever leave on top. That's how Mace screwed up. Come on, man. That's literally true.
Do you.
Just do you.
Back right now. Right. Put the fire on the fucking wax right now. Right now. She want all the eggs and one batch right. From the booth. Give it to the fandom. It's some boo. I gotta make these phantoms.
All right. Not the intro I was expecting, but again, you know, it's Bryson 5 years later, all right? We're going to have to figure out what sound, what direction he's going to go into. And, you know, right here, I feel like this is kind of the True to Self feeling instead of the Trap Soul feeling. Not that I want Trap Soul. I want him to experiment, but I'm just saying. Like, that's what we all got the base off of.
Yeah. Don't be crazy.
All right, I'm not even gonna lie. Y'all know I gotta add. Y'all know if I'm a Patreon people, y'all know I gotta add. But I feel like that intro for me, man, was definitely something I did not really want. You know, more him going to a hype kind of just rappy type song. I just didn't want that. I wanted, you know, to hear some kind of just very subtle, chill, melodic Bryson, and I feel like that's exactly the opposite direction I wanted. You know, in 5 years later, this again, depending on how the listener is, depending on how you want to listen to the album and how you are enjoying it, that's what you want to hear. That's fine for you as a fire intro. By all means, I respect that. But understand, that's not what I was here for. That's not what Devin Travell Dorsey was here for. I was here to hear some melodic shit, some chill shit, and that kind of threw me off. And
you know, I'm really not feeling the intro. Like, I'm really not feeling the intro. Now, the next track is Always and Forever. I already did, look. Now, Always and Forever was a track that I initially, when I did the video, if you guys want to look, it'll be at the end of the video, you can click it. But I initially didn't like this track. I initially thought that this track was, I didn't like it, but I felt like it was kind of just lackluster. But then as I listened to it more and more, man, this track has definitely grown on me, man. You know, it has the trap soul vibe, but it just has Bryson. You know, Bryson on the melodic shit, man, kind of just, you know, flowing through that. You know, like, I just feel, I love kind of just that, I don't know what it's really called, the alteration in the voice. I don't know if it's kind of just, I don't know if it's auto-tune or whatnot, but I just fuck with that shit, like. It's I was driving on 75. Y'all know I live in Tampa. I was driving on 75, man. And this came on my playlist because I got my playlist. And I'm like, yo, this shit kind of ride. You know, the smooth, you know, the lights hitting this shit. You know, the shoo, shoo. You know, you be driving, the lights be shoo, 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 shoo. Y'all know what I'm talking about, bro. That's exactly the noise we have when you drive. But I thought Always and Forever was definitely a grower. It's definitely a track that grew on me, man. And so far, we are one for one in the album. We got 7 more tracks left. Let's keep going. 7 more tracks. We got 8 more tracks left. Let's keep going. Track 3. I'm ready for you.
Times, but don't forget it. I'm ready. You love. You impress me, girl.
I'm not really feeling that beat. I'm not really feeling that beat either. Like. He said protect. The sample does remind me of that doo-doo. Is it woo-ah, woo-ah, boom, 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 boom. Is it Old Dirty Bastard? Wu-Tang? I think it's Wu-Tang. Yeah, this was that this sample remind me of.
Shit, Ayo nigga don't be talking about shit. That's a different shit. Maybe I'm wrong with the shit,
For me, man, that album, for me, man, it's kind of just like, did I say album? It's a track. Someone on Twitter just got to me. They just fuck with me. The track for me right there, man, it just feels like it lacks emotion. Honestly, like, it feels like it's a fire, it's like, not a fire beat, but, you know, it's definitely a melodic beat. You know, it's Bryson being Bryson, but it just lacks emotion. It lacks that feeling where you listen to a track and, you know, your heart gets warm and you get this big smile on your face and, you know, you get very euphoric and you're kind of just like in this lane. Like, I can't explain, you know, when you listen to a song and you listen to music and, like, you just know, like, it gives you that feeling of, like, you know, make up your mind. Let me stop shit. Let me chill. But, like, you know, like, when you hear it, it just touches you. And I feel like that track right there, while it was all right, it just lacked emotion for me. Honestly, it just really lacked emotion for me. That's literally it. It just lacked emotion. Just felt like it was a track that was there. Track 4, Things Change. The production on this one a little different. I'm vibing with this one. The production's a little different. Hey. In too deep and I'm referencing that trailer. In too deep. I feel like in terms of creative production, this is literally the best track so far. We got 4 tracks. This is literally the best track so far in terms of creative production. You know, I feel like he tried a little twist on this one, experiments and shit. You know, just like, you know, like, it got a little, like, Chance rap kind of feel. You know, like, like, little Miami down south, you know what I'm saying? I feel that. And actually, come to think about it, you know, Bryson Tiller, other dude from Louisville, Jack Harlow, kind of did a track like that. And, You know, like kind of had that little, you know, not trap soul, but trap sound, trap melodic. You heard, I see you cry. You see DC in my eyes. You hit DC for a drive. Through my CD out the. See you in the X. Got a little DC go go vibe to it. Hold on, let me tweet. All right, that's probably the one track that I like so far, other than Always Forever. But I think that right there, you know, having a different vibe, I like the transition at the end. A little bit different type of production there. You know, him trying a little something new. I think that, you know, it was a little upbeat. But at the same time, though, I felt like that's more kind of just, you know, the creative side instead of kind of the same old thing we got from, you know, Bryson Tiller. It's been 5 years. I don't care what y'all say. Like, it's been 5 years. All right. If you've taken a break that long, you better come with some creative shit. Like, that's fire. Again, we can compare it to Frank Ocean. Frank Ocean took that long break, and his creative mindset literally created a fucking classic of the decade, one of the greatest albums of all time, arguably. And what's that called? Our Endless, whichever one you want to go through. He created two albums that were fire. So I expect something to be fire. It's been 5 years. That's literally, I'm sorry that I have that expectation. And I'm holding it to that standard, but yeah, I mean, when you create one of the best albums of this decade, I expect you to at least give us something, you know, equivalent or better, or at least not better, but on par with that, right? I don't think that's too much to ask for, especially when it's only been one album. Track 5 is Timeless Interlude. Yeah, that's right, I'ma be okay, they be like, do the task right, don't make no mistakes, they negated. That nigga playing Among Us? Do the task right? Babies know they older now, plus I know they count on us to let more down the shoulder. This world is growing colder. Normally I'm closed off. Oh, this far, this is the playlist. If Jesus take my life, it's I made it to the greatest heights, he said. Look, son, don't be afraid of the heights and don't take prey of light. Keep me close, let's be tough. Hey, this is what I'm talking about. You saying the emotion, the feel the vibes, feel it. I can feel the words. I can feel what he's saying. It feels like there's some oomph in his voice now. I feel like there's a pulse in the track. I can't explain it, bro. But when it has a pulse, when the track is speaking to you, when it has a feeling, people will feel it. People, Right My Wrongs came on. People, Set It Off came on. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if you can break it. You know, that bitch came on. You know, everybody feels that shit across the world because it has a pulse. It has emotion. Feel it. Oh, this is a song. Oh, this is a fucking playlist. That's exactly the track that I want from Bryson. Look, I know a lot of people are going to talk about, oh, you are only when you want in this booth, trap soul, that's all you were talking about, trap soul. I already know people are going to be saying it in the comments. It's cool. I accept that. I know who I am in this world. It is what it is. People are going to be like that. That's just how it is. All right, but I just expect something to sound great from Bryson after 5 years. That's all I expect. And when I say 5 years, it's because I don't count True to Self, all right? I don't count that trash album to me. All right, I don't count that trash. When I say trash, I mean in my opinion, of course. All right, maybe in a great album, to me it was trash. So I don't count that album. I count the classic that he gave us, and I just expect him to give us, you know, something that's just going to resonate with us and give us that feeling that we had when, you know, we were on that train, you know, from Reston Will and going back to DC and being sad as fuck and looking out the window and getting your heart broken and letting Bryson Tiller mend your heart. That's literally what I want. That's what I'm looking for from Bryson Tiller. Literally, that's what I'm looking for. And I want to feel Bryson Tiller to the point where I cry. That's literally what I want to feel. Track 6, Sorrows. My God, man. Yo. My bad. All right, my bad, y'all. My bad. You know, for my Patreon people, I don't mean to stop it right here. It's a playlist. You see what I'm talking about? The emotion? Like, instantly when I heard the first 9 seconds, I'm like, damn. Like, this is what I'm talking about. I said I know. No more. And you don't miss me, babe. That's honestly, bro, I know the motherfucker can do it. I know he got the talent to do it. I know he got the capability to do it. I know he got the team around him to do it. I know he has the passion to do it. So, nigga, just do it like Nike. Just do it. Get that intro, get that years old boss shit out of here. Get that I'm ready for you shit out of here. We want this. I want this. Oh, that's fine. That's instant playlist right there. That's what I'm talking about. I don't even need to explain. I'm gonna tweet real quick. That's exactly what I'm telling you guys, man. It's literally like, when you feel a track, man, you know when a track is fire. Like, honestly, it's one of those tracks where when the track first starts and you literally start looking around in your room and you be like, yo, you don't know who the fuck you looking at. You looking at Casper. You looking at the ghost. I don't know who you looking at. Boo. You just looking around like, this is fire. You talking to the wall and shit like, this is fire. Bro, I told you. Talking to your damn self, looking like a fucking psycho because the track is so fire. You need to tell somebody. That's the feeling I am talking about when you know a track is good. The tracks, when they're fillers, they're kind of just like, oh, they're just there. All right, cool. That was a cool track, but it didn't really do nothing for me. No soul, no emotion for me. And it's kind of just like, all right, it's just a next. I've listened to so much music in the last 2 years that it's just a next track for me. It's a next track. There's literally nothing else for me to listen to. And I feel like that track is the perfect example of when a track is fire and you're going, you know, you just know. You just know it's fire. And I don't know. I gotta tweet this, bro. All right, the next track is produced by D-Pat that I found out later on, which we all know is a part of Sonder, which Sonder is the group that includes Brent Fayaz. And we all know who Brent Fayaz is anyway. Yeah, man, Inhale was a track for me. I felt like it was an interlude. I thought it was going to be the actual intro to the track. I didn't think that it was going to be somewhere in the middle of the album. After hearing Timeless Interlude and Sorrows, I feel like that's a bad placement for the track. Yes, it definitely fucks the vibe up. And a lot of you guys that listen to the album on shuffle, you guys are weirdos. But for the people that listen to albums regularly from start to finish, it definitely does fuck up the feng shui. You know, when you put a you know, you have two fire tracks and then kind of just have this slow, I don't know what he was trying to do there. The sample is cool. It's from old song SWV track, I believe you guys told me it was. Like I said, I don't know everything, so that's why you guys are here for me. You guys are like my Google. You guys told me it was an SWV sample, so, but it was all right. You know, it was nothing crazy. You know, just whatever. Next track, though, is Out of Time featuring Drake. We all know that famous picture from Drake and Bryson Tiller, and we've all been waiting for a Bryson Tiller-Drake collab, and this is it right here. So, hopefully this is fire. Hopefully this is fire. Hopefully. They were lately, I'm not sure. One thing for sure is when we're together. You know, I've heard better Drake verses. You know, I just... Go Dodgers, 3-0, baby. Discussing all that screaming, yelling's not becoming to you. Things just can't be fixed without a time. It seems like your days are dark days. It seems like you're mad. Only wait for so long. I'm not even say nothing because at this point, because you know, it makes me sound like a hater, but I'm not gonna say nothing. I just wanna listen to it slow. I mean, you know what? I'm not even gonna say nothing. You know what? Just because thank the haters and the people that get really sensitive for this, because I'm not gonna say nothing about it. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm not gonna say nothing about it. But I don't see the hype. A lot of people on my Twitter right now, they're going crazy. I just don't see the hype. I don't like that track. I feel like Sorrows and Timeless Interludes is 10 times better than that track. It just sounds like a regular track with some like 80 Simpson. It sounds normal. It just doesn't sound like there's just no effort put into it, really. It's just Drake being Drake and then Bryson just giving a verse. It just sounds like, you know, always forever, you know, freaking things change track. That's what it sounds like. Whatever, man. Track 9, keep doing what you're doing. Man. I wish I believed. I wish I believed in you. And no matter what, keep doing what you're doing. That's what I feel like I'm about to cry. I don't know why I'm about to cry. Like, I'm not even sad. Like, that's exact. I gotta tweet it. I can't explain the feeling. Like, the feeling you get when you hear, like, a heartfelt track. It's kind of just like when Lenny Williams, I Really Love You comes on. Like, when Prince, Purple Rain comes on. When, you know, Isley Brothers, Voyage to Atlantis comes on. When Frank Ocean, you know, White Ferrari comes on. You know what I'm saying? When Pyramids, when the second half of Pyramids hit for Frank Ocean. You know what I'm saying? Like, tracks like that where it just captures you in the moment. I can't explain what that feeling is. It's just something that you either feel or you don't feel. It's either something that runs through the course of your body or it doesn't. But like, when I'm hearing this track, this is the track I can instantly hear that he is really fucked up right now. Like that, and that's what I'm saying. Like, keep doing it. You gotta keep it moving. Gotta keep it. Now come out with a beat, come out with a beat, come out with a beat. You know what? It was crazy, man. When that nigga Bryson hit, dog, Bryson just hit. I gotta play it out. Yeah. Strellis. Hit me with it, Strellis. You know when a song fire? I be telling you. You know when a song fire and you just be staring, like you staring at the shit at the minute bar going this way. It's just like as the song's finishing. I don't know what that shit does, but I be looking at it like it's actually gonna do some kind of animation. It ain't. It really ain't. That's literally the best song on here. That's literally the best song on here next to Sorrows. That's, bro, hold on. Bryson Tiller, keep doing what you're doing. Slow. Come on, bro. Damn, nobody got it? Nobody got it slow? I'm disappointed. That's the one right there. That is literally the one. That's the fire. Yup. That's the fire, bro. Like, next track is next to you. I like the. After hearing Keep Doing What You're Doing, Out of Time, like I said, was all right. Inhale Sorrows, Timeless Interlude. The second half of the album is definitely more solid than the first half, of course. But I definitely love this outro. This outro is definitely the outro I would have chose and what a, you know, the direction I would have wanted from him. I don't know about y'all, but I would have not felt really well with a hype track to end the album. You know, like, especially when Right My Wrongs was the end. And even, what's that called? Always Outro and Something Tells Me was also the, you know, last two tracks on True to Self. So he's always kind of just had that way of kind of just exiting, you know, in a nice melodic chill way. All right, man, I'm going to say it like this, man. This is my opinion on the album, even if you want to call it. Look, I'm going to call it an album because that's what he released as. There's two albums coming, apparently. You got this one, and there's one in the winter. So I would just say that this is the EP. Maybe this is the first half of the two albums that are supposed to come out. Anniversary, we all know Trap Soul's anniversary was, what, last month? Or was it this month? I think it was like 2 weeks ago. So perfect title for what this album is, after making a return after his album. Looks just like Trap Soul, except he's looking in the other direction. You know, little symbolism there, man. Definitely probably could just be, you know, he's on the opposite side now where he was when he did Trap Soul. First track called Years Go By. Again, I didn't like that uplifting, that upbeat type of beat. But I felt like the album definitely did get better as the time went on. And I think that, you know, look, most Bryson Tiller fans are going to, they want a post-Trap Soul.
most Bryson Tiller stans are going to be like, you know what, they just wanted him to come back and make good music. They're just listening to it. For me, man, it doesn't really change whether it is or not. Yes, I have expectations. Yes, I have high hopes. But if a track is fire, like, a track is fire, that really doesn't change for me at all. Like, if a track is fire, it's kind of just like, example, when I heard D to the A, right? D to the A, it was out of nowhere. It was a Lil Yachty. It was a T Grizzly track, one of my favorite tracks still in the last 5 years. And I just liked it. You know, I hated Lil Yachty at the time. I still dislike Lil Yachty as an artist. I respect him as, you know, Moneymaker Hustler, but as an artist, I do not like Lil Yachty. And that track came on, and as much as I dislike Lil Yachty, that shit is fire. I know the Lil Yachty verse. I be jamming in the car, in the coupe, 16 speakers. I be telling y'all. And I feel like, for me, that doesn't hinder anything for as much music as I listen to in my lifetime, because I just like music. I put it on my playlist, and that's how I go. It's my playlist. It's my own album. I just think that the tracks on here that I really didn't like, Years Go By, I'm Ready For You, Out of Time featuring Drake, was definitely a disappointment. I expected better for those two to have a kind of a mediocre, really meh track. I just thought it was kind of just like, oh, we're Drake, you know, I'm Bryson, get on track together, we're gonna do something, not doing anything crazy, which I could like. If you want a perfect example, what was fire, Drake, Chris Brown, No Guidance, that's a track that was fucking fire, all right? That's some umph, that's some emotion right there. That's what you could have did. But my favorite tracks on here being Keep Doing What You're Doing, number one, Sorrows, number two, Timeless Intro, Timeless Interlude, number two, Sorrows, number three. And then I gotta go with, like, Next to You. I think that was the four tracks on here. I'm not saying this is a bad, there's only 10 tracks on here, so it's really hard to kind of critique it. Look, if you really want to talk about it, there were 7 tracks on here that I enjoy, or 6 tracks on here that I enjoy. There's 4 that I would skip. So you could put it 64 whatever you want it. If that's one a rating you want to give it, I would say it's a 7.5 out of 10, honestly. There wasn't anything too, like, eye-popping, at least for the first listen. 7.5 out of 10 is a first listen. Again, I always change it when I listen to it again. Big Sean's album definitely, it went up 0.5 when I heard it again for the multiple times. There's some other albums that went down when I heard it multiple times. So, just because a first listen, you know, maybe the Drake track might grow on me. Usually how Drake does grow on me. The intro, I don't think the intro's going to ruin me. I think that was just a bad selection. And I also think that there was a bad choice of track listing with Inhale. I think Inhale should have kind of just been like more number two, or even the intro. You know, I think that could have just been there as well. I'm not trying to take this too serious, because the real album, what it's called, Serenity, is supposed to be coming in the wintertime. So that's when I guess we'll say that the album. I'll tell you one thing right now. I tell you this right here. If we don't get a Serenity, though, I don't want to hear it. All right? I don't want to hear it. But I do think that, after, you know, such a long time and being out of music, I think for me, man, what I really expected was, I just expected him to do a little bit more experimentation, to find another sound, to kind of just do what he wants to do. He's had the success. The floodgates were open with Trap Soul. He was able to make music. He was able to do what he wanted to do. I just thought that having all of that going for you and all this time, you know, like, give us something creative. Give us something that's going to stick with a lot of people that we're going to, you know, we're going to sit back, we're going to enjoy. And that's all I wanted. So that's kind of just where I looked at it as a consumer. So get in the comment box below, man. Let me know what you think, man. Let me know what's your favorite track. Let me know what you thought about the EP, the album, whatever you want to call it. Let me know what was your worst track. Let me know how you feel about the Drake feature. If you think Drake actually did a good thing on here. Because Drake was the only one that was featured on here. That's what's really crazy. Drake was the only one that was featured on here. So it seems like Drake is just all over the place. You know, Drake's going to be on everybody's album before he releases his own album. Get in the comment box below, man. Let me know what you think, man. Get in the comment box below. Let me know what you think. Follow me on social media, what you want to hear. Get a video of 3,000 likes, man. We get a new vinyl on the wall. And yeah, man, this is how it is. If you want to watch the full video, it is on Patreon. That's the best way to get it, is on Patreon. Don't get mad at me because, yo, Dev, you clipped it. Too much clipping, too much clipping. You want to watch the full video, it's on Patreon. All right, that's how that it is. It is what it is. And we'll keep it like that, man. Until next time, this is me, Boy Dev. We out. Peace.